गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, आई एम अगेन विद यू विद द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ क्लास 12th चैप्टर विस्टास बुक चैप्टर 2 द टाइगर किंग. इन फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड पार्ट वील कम टू नो दैट अ टाइगर किंग वॉज बोर्न एंड वेन ही वॉज बोर्न एंड वेन ही वॉज ओनली ऑफ 10 डेज ओल्ड ही आस्क्ड एन इंटेलिजेंट क्वेश्चन अबाउट हिज द मैनर ऑफ हिज डेथ टू द एस्ट्रोलॉजर्स एंड दे टोल्ड हिम दैट ही शुड बी बिवेयर ऑफ टाइगर्स एंड देन ही प्रोनाउंस एंड सेड दैट इट्स द टाइगर्स हु शुड बी बिवेयर ऑफ him and in the second part we'll come to know that his childhood was quite normal as the children of royal families and when he came at the age of 20 he got his states also got his estate also and when the rumor come to him that he should be beware of tigers he started tiger hunting and when the very first tiger he killed he called the astrologers and asked them to say something about that then the astrologer said that the king might kill 99 tigers but he should be aware of 100th tiger and if the 100th tiger was killed by the king the astrologer would change his profession from astrology to insurance agent let's read the third part to know more about Tiger King. From that day onward, it was celebration time for all the tigers inhabiting Pratibandhpuram. And it was the time for celebration for the tigers who lived in Pratibandhpuram. So how it would be the day or the time for the celebration for tigers? Let's see. The state banned tiger hunting by anyone except Maharaja. Now it was banned, the tiger hunting was banned in the state, but only Maharaja could kill the tigers. A proclamation, orders were issued to the effect that if anyone dared to fling so much as to stone at a tiger, all his wealth and property would be confiscated. And it was an order was announced from the royal family, from the royal court, that if anyone would dare to even to dare or throw a stone toward at a tiger his wealth and property would be confiscated means uski property ko chhin liya jayega the maharaja vowed he would attend to all other matters only after killing 100 tigers and also maharaja took oath that he would kill or he would look after his court only after killing 100 tigers. Initially, the king seemed well set to realize his ambition, and in the starting, he was well set with his ambition means of killing the tigers. Not that he faced no dangers. It doesn't mean that the king was so courageous or you can say so expert on tiger hunting that he killed all the tigers. Sometimes it was not always that he. He has not faced any dangers. There were times when the bullet missed its mark when he was about to kill the tiger and his bullet missed the mark and the tiger leapt upon him or tiger ne uske upar chhalang laga. He fought the beast with his bare hands and he had to fought with the tiger with bare hands means without any ammunition or means. Each time it was the Maharaja who won and every time Maharaja won over tiger. At another time he was in danger of losing his throne and it happens that one time once there was a time when he was about to lose his throne a high ranking British officer visited Pratibandhpuram he was very fond of hunting tigers and fonder of being photographed with the tigers he had shot as usual he wished to hunt tigers in Pratibandhpuram but the Maharaja was firm in his resolve. He refused permission. Maharaja was firm in his resolve and he refused permission. I can organize any other hunt. You may go on a boar hunt. You may conduct a mouse hunt or we are ready for a mosquito hunt too. But tiger hunt, that's impossible. Once it happens that the tiger and the Maharaja was about to lose his throne because one day a high ranking British officer visited Pratibandhpuram and as he was very fond of hunting tigers he asked Maharaja to have a tiger hunt in his state but Maharaja was so firm of his oath that he did not allow that British officer to hunt tigers, and he said that except of hunting tigers, he could hunt any boar, any mosquito or any mouse. The British officer secretary sent word to Maharaja through the Diwan that the Durai himself did not have to kill the tiger. The Maharaja could do the actual killing. What was important to the Durai was a photograph of himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. But the Maharaja would not agree even to this proposal. If he relented now, what would he do if other British officer turned up for tiger hunts? Now, when the British officer asked for tiger hunting and Maharaja denied his proposal, again he sent his word from his Diwan that the Maharaja would do the killing, and the main thing is to have the photograph of the British officer with the tiger's carcass. Carcass means dead body of animal. So British officers just want a photograph with the killed tiger, but Maharaja would not agree even with this proposal, because he said that if he would ready with this proposal, the other British officer also come with this request. Because he prevented a British officer from fulfilling his desire, the Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom itself, as the British officer's rule was there in that time in country. So Maharaja was in danger of losing his throne because he has denied the proposal of a British officer and of fulfilling his desire of tiger hunting or even have a photograph with the dead tiger. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberations over this issue. As a result, a telegram was dispatched forthwith to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta, send samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs. Some 50 rings arrived. The Maharaja sent the whole lot to the British officer's good lady. The king and the minister expected the Durai Sani to choose one or two rings and send the rest back. Within no time at all, the Durai Sani sent her the reply, "Thank you very much for your gifts." Many talks were there about this tiger hunting proposal between Maharaja and Diwan, but at last what happened, Maharaja sent a telegram to the British company's jeweler in Calcutta, and he asked that jeweler to send the samples of beautiful or expensive diamond rings. And when he sent about 50 rings samples, Maharaja sent all those rings to British officer's wife, and he thought that the British officer or his wife would choose one or two rings out of those 50 rings, but the message was came that "Thank you very much for your gifts," means they kept all those rings with them. In 2 days, a bill of 3 lakh of rupees came from the British jewelers. The Maharaja was happy that though he had lost 3 lakh of rupees, he had managed to retain his kingdom. And when he got the message of a bill of 3 lakh rupees, the Maharaja was happy because he has saved his throne from the British rule. Another thing, he also was happy over the proposal that now the British officer won't come with that proposal of tiger hunting. The Maharaja's tiger's hunt continued to be highly successful. Within 10 days, he was able to kill. Within 10 years, he was able to kill 70 tigers, and then an unforeseen hurdle brought his mission to a standstill. The tiger population became extinct in the forest of Pratibandhapuram. Now, since the part 3, we'll come to know that tiger hunting was started by Maharaja, and even the British officers was denied to have tiger hunting, and for this he had to pay 3 lakh rupees. Within the time of 10 years, Maharaja had killed three Maharaj had killed 70 tigers, but after that a problem was occurred in his mission, and that was that the tiger population was become extinct, or you can say was finished from his state Pratibandhapuram. Who knows whether the tigers practiced birth control or committed harakiri or simply ran away from the state because they desired to be shot by British hands only. And the reason was unknown that why these population of tigers was extinct from the state, because there were a lot of tigers in Pratibandhapuram, and after 70 tigers it becomes extinct population in that state. And now the reason of that it is not known, because nobody knows that whether they practiced birth control or any other, or maybe they ran away from the state because they wanted to be shot by the British hands. One day, the Maharaja sent for Diwan. Diwan Sahib, aren't you aware of the fact that 30 tigers still remain to be shot down by the gun of mine? He asked, brandishing his gun. He called the Diwan and asked him that still 30 tigers were there to be killed from his gun. And shuddering at the sight of the gun, Diwan Sahib cried out, "Your Majesty, I am not a tiger. Which idiot would call you a tiger? No, I am not a gun. You are neither tiger nor gun. Diwan Sahib, I summoned you here for a different purpose. I have decided to get married." Now, when at the sight of gun, Diwan Sahib was frightened, and different words come from his mouth. He said that he is not a tiger. Then Maharaja called that who's that idiot called you a tiger? Then he said that he did not even a gun, and he said that the Maharaja said that he's not even a tiger, not a gun. But Maharaja called him for some another purpose, and that purpose was that he wanted to get married. Diwan began to babble even more. "Your Majesty, I have two wives already. If I marry you..." Now Diwan Sahib again was frightened, and nonsense came from his mouth, and in his babbling voice he said that he had only two wives and how he could marry the king. "Don't talk nonsense. Why should I marry you? What I want is a tiger." Now again Maharaja said that he did not want to marry that Diwan Sahib, but he wanted a tiger. "Your Majesty, please think it over. Your ancestors were married to the sword. If you like, marry the gun. A tiger king is more than enough for this state. It doesn't need a tiger queen as well." And then Diwan again misunderstood it, and he said that if Maharaja wanted to marry a tiger, it won't be a good idea, because his ancestors were married to sword, or even if Maharaja wanted to get married, he could marry a gun. But this state did not want any tiger queen. Tiger king is enough for this state of Pratibandhapuram. The Maharaja gave a loud crack of laughter. At this, Maharaja started laughing. "I'm not thinking of marrying either a tiger or a gun, but a girl from the ranks of human beings. First, you may draw up statistics of tiger populations in the different native states. Next, you may investigate if there is a girl I can marry in the royal family of the state with a large tiger population." And the main purpose now, after laughing, Maharaja told Diwan Sahib his main purpose, that he wanted to get married just because of tiger killing, and he wanted to marry the girl only of the royal family who has a large number of tigers in their state. And first of all, he wanted Diwan Sahib to have a statistics of tiger population, and whose state has a great number of tigers. Only in that family Maharaja would get married. The Diwan followed his orders. He found the girl, right girl, from the state which possessed a large number of tigers, and his orders were fulfilled. And even Diwan Sahib found a girl of the state which state has a number of tigers. Maharaja Jang Bahadur killed 5 or 6 tigers each time he visited his father-in-law in this manner. 99 tigers skin adorned the walls of the reception hall in the Pratibandhapuram palace. Now Maharaja, whenever Maharaja Jang Bahadur went to his father-in-law's house, there he go for tiger hunting, and at least 5 or 6 tigers each time he killed there, and according to this and gradually he killed 99 tigers, and these all tiger skins were adorned, or you can say decorated, in the Pratibandhapuram palace hall, reception hall. So this is third and fourth part of this chapter is completed, and my video with the part fifth will come soon. And till your work is to read the chapter, to watch the video carefully, like and subscribe and share. Thank you. Have a nice day.